Now every step take after we break, there's nothing we can do. The next heart beats, you feel it to me. There's nothing we can do. Nothing can hold us back. Let's make the moment last. Have a day, it won't fade away. Cause baby, we were born to win. Just climb up the ladder and give a helping hand. Sometimes it's harder than all you need is some time. It'll take you a few days to finally understand. Got to push harder. The failures only make you strong. I used to be so careless, careless. But now I'm more than fearless, fearless. Don't stop yourself, cause the world itself we're made to be broken. Hear it, I'm on it. Now every step we take, boundary we break. There's nothing we can do, do, do. Even if it's hard to see, just a feel to me. There's nothing you can do, do, do. Nothing can hold us back. Let's make the moment last. If you have a win, won't fade away. Cause baby, we were born to win.
Now every step take on the way goes.
Here we go. Let's go. Let's go. Ladies and gentlemen, 28 inspiring and phenomenal women, and only one of them will be your new queen. These Filipinas are on the rise and ready to shine from the Philippines to the universe.
Now every step take on the way goes. Born to win.
We were born to win.
The long wait is finally over, and we meet again for the highly anticipated beauty pageant in the country. My name is Casey Montero, and I am honored to be back to host Miss Universe Philippines 2021. Round of applause. Yes. Humans, I see humans. A new batch of phenomenal and inspiring women are going all out for the most coveted crown in the country after they went through various challenges. We are live right now at Henan Resort Alona Beach with our beautiful candidates in the equally beautiful province of Bohol, one of the most visited destinations in the Central Visayas region. Known to be God's little paradise, this is definitely the best place to celebrate these Filipinos who are on the rise here to shine for the rest of the universe. Let's meet the phenomenal and inspiring women in their sheen dresses.
I had during the pandemic. Other than cooking and baking, I decided to take up 3 online Harvard courses. Now that's being smart with my time. Janella Joy Cuaton, Miss Albay.
Angeles.
I believe that I'm not only beautiful, but also a smart woman who balanced 3 scholarships in college while having part-time jobs. In 2017, I became a regional awardee of the 10 Outstanding Students of the Philippines. Mirhan Hipolito, Miss Angeles.
Cavite.
I graduated with a double master's in architecture and heritage conservation. Despite being a self-proclaimed bookworm, I am also an adrenaline junkie. So you'll never know if you'll see me diving into history books or into the ocean with whale sharks. Victoria Velasquez Vincent, Miss Cavite.
Isabella.
I am a spiritual person and I am proud to say I am a woman after God's own heart. I pride myself in being a life giver. I am an artist.
Jan Luisa Bejero, Miss Isabella.
Laguna.
Blessed to be raised in the province, I am a natural wanderer and nature lover. I am also a thalassophile. I find peace and serenity in the sea and beaches. Laren May Magnaya Bautista, Miss Laguna.
Marinduque.
I'm an incoming freshman at the De La Salle University, and I aspire to become a neurosurgeon in the future. I advocate for LGBTQ+ rights, having been raised by two gay dads. Simone Dean Bernilia, Miss Marinduque.
Masbate.
I am a miracle baby. I am the only survivor of my mom's 8 pregnancies. I woke up from a coma at 6 years old. Having lived in Masbate for 15 years, I am a proud Provinciana at heart, with love for the simplest things. Kirsten Daniel Dalavin, Miss Masbate.
Pangasinan.
I am terrified of heights, but the right motivation pushed me to do extreme things like bungee jump and skydive just to conquer my fears. Marine Krista Rabowitz, Miss Pangasinan.
Romblon.
I wore braces during senior high school but removed them every time I joined pageants. In a span of 2 years, I was in 8 pageants. That's a lot of time in the dentist. Jane Nicole Miñano, Miss Romblon.
Makati.
I am a magna cum laude graduate at De La Salle University, but I know how to socialize since I love making my fellow delegates laugh. Would it be hard to believe when I say I had no boyfriend since birth? Isabel de los Santos, Miss Makati.
Manduluyong.
I love to travel. I loved it so much that I actually lived in Spain for almost a year, where I worked as an English teacher. Aside from learning about the culture, I learned mostly to be an independent woman. Maria Corazon Avalos, Miss Mandaluyong.
Manila.
I started an online vegetable business as a way to help struggling farmers during the pandemic. I was also invited to exhibit my artworks for the first time during the pandemic and was mentioned in a few articles.
Isabella Jasmine A. O'Malley, Miss Manila.
Paranaque.
I was born into a family of accomplished artists and athletes. I like to rough it out sometimes, from playing basketball with my brothers to hunting down the best hole-in-the-wall restaurants with my friends. Ingrid Santa Maria, Miss Paranaque.
Pasig.
I am a licensed pharmacist and an international flight attendant, but I also have an artistic side. I am a Filipino folk dancer and I perform all over the Philippines and abroad. Princess Krista Singh, Miss Pasig.
San Juan.
I know how to have fun and how to get work done. I am both a TikTok content creator and a 2-time TED speaker. I believe that life is too short to put yourself in a box. Rosane Marie Bernos, Miss San Juan.
Taguig.
I am a TV host, medical assistant, and now working on my second college degree as a nurse. I also love adventure, hiking waterfalls, and learning how to cook new recipes. Katrina Demaranan, Miss Taguig.
Aklan.
I consider myself a goal-getter. Moving to the Philippines was a huge leap for me in terms of finding my independence. It's that same drive that I hope will propel me towards the crown. Cristel Abelio, Miss Aklan.
Antique.
I am a former scholar of De La Salle College of St. Benilde, a black belt taekwondo athlete and a former member of the Philippine national team. I think that's beauty, brains, and brawn. Nolan Rose Mabuhay Campos, Miss Antique.
Cebu City.
I am a Philippine Navy Marines reservist, a proud member of the LGBTQIA+ community, and a community development worker who works with children who are in conflict with the law. Beatriz Luigi Gomez, Miss Cebu City.
Cebu Province.
I am a self-proclaimed Queen Dara who has been selling stuff since my high school days. I became a Santo Niño devotee at 16 after winning Sinulog Festival Queen. Steffi Rose Abirastori, Miss Cebu Province.
Iloilo City.
I am an Ilongga of Filipino, Malaysian, Indian descent. I am a basketball player and plays for Iloilo City. I am a graduate of Aircraft Maintenance Technology. Kesha Pornam Ramachandran, Miss Iloilo City.
Negros Oriental.
I am not a degree holder yet, but with my help, one of my sisters will be graduating soon. And as an overseas Filipino worker, I've traveled to 48 countries and was able to build a comfortable house for my mama and siblings. Grace Charmaine Banwa Vindiola, Miss Negros Oriental.
Bukidnon.
I worked in Phuket, Thailand, and came home for the Miss Universe Philippines pageant. I love to sing and used to be a vocalist in different bands. Aside from being a surfer and skater, I am also a certified open water scuba diver. Megan Julia Roa Digal, Miss Bukidnon.
Cagayan de Oro.
Miss Universe 2015, Pia Alonzo Wurzbach and I have something in common. We came from the same school where she studied in her elementary days, and now I am a teacher there. Vinci Labadan Vacalares, Miss Cagayan de Oro.
Davao del Sur.
I am of Filipino Solomon Islander descent. I started working at the age of 18 in order to help my family since then. I started taking online classes to balance work and school. I know what it's like to be taking online classes under the stress of the pandemic. Jadaida Hefervis Corinihona, Miss Davao del Sur.
Davao Occidental.
I can say that I represent the best from the three major islands of the Philippines. My father is from Luzon, my mother from the Visayas, and here I am as a representative from Mindanao. Crisaline May Valencia, Miss Davao Occidental.
Misamis Oriental.
I am one of the most fun-loving and high-spirited delegates. I am of Filipino, American, German, and Irish descent. I'm also an island girl and loves to study the stars. Trello Grace Faulkner, Miss Misamis Oriental.
Siargao Island.
I love watching psychological thrillers and documentaries. For fun, I can use the hula hoop for hours. That's a great way to keep me in shape. Michelle Angela Navarro Ocol, Miss Siargao Island.
phenomenal. That's all I can say about this batch of Miss Universe Philippines contenders. One of them is set to inspire you with their grit, passion, and determination. But for now, let's check out what's happening backstage with our equally beautiful and phenomenal correspondents, Miss Universe Philippines 2020 second runner-up, Michelle Gumabao, and last year's first runner-up, Bella Ismael.
Thank you so much to our dashing host, Casey Montero. Hello, everyone. We are backstage here at the Miss Universe Philippines 2021. Didn't we just enjoy that presentation of the candidates, Bella?
Absolutely, Michelle. I mean, just look at our candidates now. Some of our candidates are here wearing their gorgeous sheen dresses.
Thank you so much for rushing to meet us. You girls look lovely. So joining us here right now is Miss Pangasinan, Miss Taguig, and Miss Masbate. Kisses, Katrina and Maureen. Thank you so much for joining us right now.
Thank you for being here. We are very happy to be here.
You guys look gorgeous. Kisses. Oh my goodness. Look at this beautiful pink dress. It really is your color, isn't it?
Thank you. It is.
What is it like feeling? What does it feel like wearing a sheen dress?
You know, Bella, it feels really great. This dress really was for me because my 18th birthday gown was this color. So I really in my element right now.
Perfect.
Beautiful. And Katrina, you really stood out in your little black dress. Tell us more about what you love with this sheen dress.
I love how, I mean, as you guys know, in the prelims, I also wore black. So just very powerful. I love the classy shoulders and also, of course, the slit.
Oh, yeah.
Classy, but sexy.
We love a good slit. And of course, with sheen, you wear your wonderful. So Maureen, how does it feel like wearing this wonderful sheen dress for you?
I just feel really confident and beautiful wearing this. I know you can agree because you wore this dress too.
But you look great in it.
Thank you. You too. And I also love this slit. But I feel really beautiful wearing this.
Perfect. You know, that's exactly what we need to be feeling tonight.
I agree. And on stage, all of you look confident, comfortable, and wonderful. So thank you so much, ladies, for inspiring everyone to wear your wonderful all the time. We'll see you guys later. But up next, let's get to know the winners of our first set of special awards. And right after, the announcement of our top 16. All that and more when the Miss Universe Philippines 2021 returns.
I am going to show you one of my secrets to a healthy and glowing skin, and that relies strongly in two words, sun protection.
Sun care is self-care.
Whether we're spending 5 minutes or 5 hours outdoors, exposed on our gadget screens longer than usual,
forced to train, run, and swim under the scorching heat of the sun.
These harmful light rays cause premature aging to the skin
and trigger my hyperpigmentation and dryness.
And that is why I use Bellasun Expert Translucent Loose Powder with SPF 30
and their tinted sunscreen with SPF 50, which also acts as our foundation substitute.
It's so easy to use, you can touch up and protect your skin wherever you are.
It's a win-win when it comes to Bellasun Expert products.
I am universe ready.
Now I'm protected wherever I go while still looking fabulous.
I'm able to touch up my skin, protect it, and look effortlessly good wherever I go.
I am sun protected only with Bella.
You are still tuned in to Miss Universe Philippines 2021. This phenomenal pageant is happening right here on this beautiful island. Let me greet you all, maajong pag-abot, and welcome to our province of Bohol, also dubbed as God's little paradise. Hi, Billy.
Hello, Pauline. And maajong gabi-i, Universe. And can I just say, Bohol is love. Like, whenever I'm here, I always have an amazing time. And I'm pretty sure all the girls had an amazing time as we tour around the province as well. And now, they're gonna go back up on stage looking super stunning and super excited because we are about to set the first set of awards.
That's right. Who among these phenomenal ladies will be bringing home these special awards? Much is in store for us, so let's not keep you waiting. Casey? Back to you.
Thank you to our phenomenal correspondents, Miss Universe Philippines 2020 fourth runner-up, Billy Hackinson, and of course, last year's third runner-up, my favorite person in all of Bohol, the pride of Bohol, Pauline Amalinx. We're friends, guys. Just want to let you know that. The Miss Universe Philippines is made possible by our generous sponsors. They share the same vision and values with the Miss Universe Philippines organization. We can't thank you enough for your support and generosity. And with the 28 girls on stage, our brand partners have chosen the winners for our first set of special awards. All right. Our face of Bello, Sun Expert, will take home 100,000 pesos with 1 year supply of Bello Sun Expert products. It is the face of Bello Sun Expert is Taguig. Congratulations, Katrina Dimaranan. In this time of pandemic, it is important to stay safe in style. Receiving 300,000 pesos cash with a 1 year supply of copper masks, our copper mask Miss Copper Mask is Pasig, Princess Krista Singh. Our next winner will take home 300,000 pesos in cash and a 1 year supply of organic barley, the superfood of the century. You are the Miss Organic Barley Laguna. Laren May Bautista, congratulations. Our Miss K-Pads will win 300,000 pesos in cash plus a 1 year supply of K-Pads. She is Albay, Janella Joy Quaton. The official testing sponsor of Miss Universe Philippines, SafePoint Plus, is giving away 50,000 pesos in cash plus testing credits from SafePoint. You are Miss SafePoint Plus. Taguig. Official airline sponsor AirAsia is a recipient of Skytrax 2021 World's Best Low-Cost Airline for 12 consecutive years, giving unlimited round-trip tickets to any of its destinations. This year's Miss AirAsia Philippines is Pangasinan, Maureen Robowitz. The next award is from Jojo Bregaya's Shoes. For our winner, she will definitely walk and win with 50,000 pesos plus 1 year supply of shoes. Miss Bregaya's is Laguna. Laren May Bautista, congratulations again. The Miss RFOX Special Award celebrates the beauty and grace of a modern and progressive Filipina who sees the value of what emerging technologies can offer. This special award goes to the candidate who garnered the highest votes during the voting period from September 24 to the 28th. The winning beauty queen, who will be awarded the first ever Miss Red Fox Special Award, will get to take home $2,000 in cash, and another $2,000 will be donated to her chosen charity or advocacy. And she is Masbate! Our next special award is from our official residence. Our Miss Hennen will receive 6-night stay in a premier room with direct pool access at Hennen Resort Alona Beach, Bohol, right where we're at. And she is... Pangasinan! To wrap up the first set of special awards, last September 23, we celebrated the bygone era of elegance and sophistication as these ladies transformed into Manila Carnival Queens, which is the theme of this year's national costume. You may now celebrate because you are this year's best in national costume. That goes to... Mandaluyong! Maria Corazon Abalos. Congratulations to our first set of special award winners. You are truly phenomenal. Right now, let's take a peek at what our lovely ladies purchased from Lazada, something that they can actually relate to during their journey for the crown.
One item from Lazada that I can relate to my Miss Universe journey would have to be a red lipstick. Because whenever I put it on, I feel so confident and I feel so empowered, like all my prior insecurities have gone away. And it makes me feel that I am ready to face the universe as a red-lipped woman. A pair of shoes, because it represents confidence and humility, that no matter how far I'll go, I'll walk confidently and do my best.
I had to keep myself busy. My income got affected, but I really need to find a way. So I'd say that the clothes that I got from Lazada that I sell online. I guess that makes me my discarte.
An eco-friendly dining set. I've actually bought several sets of this for my team members back at home because we Filipinos just love to eat. I'm a collaborative person and sharing a meal together is the best place to do just that.
Because of the pandemic, it's become unsafe to go out and do photo shoots all the time. But thanks to Lazada, I have found the perfect tripod that has helped me adapt to current times. It has enhanced my pre-existing versatility, and I'm able to do self-photo shoots in the comfort and safety of my own home. No studio, no problem. Pang shoot sa bahay lang, na sa Lazada yan.
Is a vinyl record player, because I think that in every goal that I pursue, it's like a never-ending song that continuously plays. It's so full of surprises.
Coming into this competition, I needed to go to shoots that required hairstyling that completely damaged my curls. Good thing Lazada offers hair essentials like this hairstyler that helped me regain my bouncy curls.
It'd probably be affirmation cards, especially now during our theme in Miss Universe Philippines as hashtag inspire you. I truly believe that in order for you to be able to inspire others, you first have to be able to inspire yourself.
It would be a pair of heels. This footwear gives me the confidence and the drive to strut my way to the universe with my head held high.
A portable steamer. As someone who has been in the industry for a while, I am required to look presentable and confident wherever I am and wherever I go. And that, of course, means wearing wrinkle-free clothes.
Pieces, what's your favorite record?
My favorite record is Nasa Lazada Yan.
Hear Lazada, you have the jingle in your head, right? So maybe we can all do that together. Ready? Nasa Lazada. Yes. They're all wearing face masks, but I'm pretty sure they said yan. Okay. In May 2021, the Miss Universe Philippines organization started the search for the next phenomenal woman who will represent our country in the Miss Universe 2021 pageant. From hundreds of online applicants, the 100 was selected, actually, 100 from hundreds. These ladies took on the headshot and video introduction challenges. Then the top 75 moved forward to the next round. From those 75, only 50 advanced to the next phase of the competition after the runway and casting video challenges. Those 50 contenders competed in a virtual interview challenge that was the basis of the Miss Universe Philippines organization to determine its official top 30 contestants. Tonight, we started the competition with 28 official candidates, but only 5 will reach the final round. 2 of them will be awarded either second runner-up and first runner-up, while the other 2 will have a new crown. Yes, 2 new crowns this year, Miss Universe Philippines Charity and Miss Universe Philippines Tourism. The Miss Universe Philippines organization believes that these new titles would help inspire more women to advocate for their causes. And of course, the last phenomenal woman standing will be the Miss Universe Philippines 2021. That makes our competition even more exciting with the new titles. And we will meet the new queens a little bit later on. But for now, we have to say goodbye to 12 of them. It's time for us to find out who our top 16 are in no particular order. Advancing to the top 16 with the highest votes in Lazada voting page. Congratulations to Masbate, Kristen Danielle Delevingne,
item I got from Lazada that I can relate to my journey to the crown is a vinyl record player, because I think that in every goal that I pursue, it's like a never-ending song that continuously plays. It's so full of surprises. In every song, there's so much melody, so much harmony and rhythm, and I think sometimes we would want to fast forward to the best parts, but really the best thing to do is just listen to the moment and enjoy the music, whether it is on a Miss Universe stage or whether you're in your pajamas. I think the best thing to do is just enjoy the moment, own it, and never be afraid of making mistakes.
So, Kisses, what's your favorite record?
My favorite record is Nasa Lazada Yan.
Next up, take your spot, Pangasinan. You still have a shot for the crown, Aklan. Make way for Misamis Oriental. This is your moment, Manila. Down, 11 more to go. You are part of the top 16. Congratulations, Albay. Seven must be your lucky number. Congratulations to Cavite. Step closer to the crown, Angeles City. cheer up because you are in. Mandaluyong! It's your turn to celebrate, Taguig! Six more spots left. Come join the fun. Congratulations to Cebu Province! Up next, congratulations to Laguna. Claim your spot, Paranaque. Only three spots remain to be filled. One of them belongs to Romblon. You prayed for this and now it has been answered. Congratulations, you have entered the top 16, San Juan. Wrapping up the top 16, she is none other than Cebu City. Presenting your Miss Universe Philippines 2021 top 16. Congratulations, ladies. Another round of applause for your top 16. All right. A beauty that cares is truly inspiring and phenomenal. This is why Front Row is a proud presenter of the Miss Universe Philippines pageant. They share the same vision and passion that the organization does. They shine up front for everyone in the universe to see.
Sama-sama tayo sa kahit anumang pagsubok.
Luzon, Visayas o Mindanao, pili kang aabutin ang Front Row Cares.
Para sa kalusugan, edukasyon at magandang kalagayan ng lahat.
Dahil sa ating pagtutulungan, kaya natin lagpasan ang kahit anumang laban.
Sabay-sabay nating harapin ang mas magandang bukas para sa Pilipinas.
Kaya wag na wag mawawala ng pag-asa.
Dahil marami pa din ang gustong tumulong.
Magdami pa din ang handang magbigay.
At parating kasama nyo ang Front Row Cares.
And the heart of the Filipino to the rest of the universe.
Ako si RS.
Ako si Sam.
At katulong ng inyong front row business partners,
kami ang inyong kasama sa oras ng inyong pangangailangan.
Front row cares for you. Front row cares for the universe.
All right. You know, these beauty pageants are definitely very, very difficult. They are very hard to throw, and they are also very hard to host. But the people who have the hardest jobs are the people who I'm about to talk about right now. We are still live here right now in Bohol for Miss Universe Philippines. For sure, everyone is watching us right now. We're live, guys. This is something that we haven't done in a long time, and they're enjoying the show. And let me just say that everyone is nervous, possibly for their bets to see if they're going to win the crown. Here in the Philippines, we all know that pageants are taken very seriously. I know this for a fact by the amount of comments that I got as I announced that I was hosting this show. I'll read them all now on Instagram. No, I won't do it. It's too long. Just for all of you people that are watching right now, I've had 16 energy drinks, I've had 14 cups of coffee, I've had 2 espressos and 4 cups of sugar. I'm ready to go. So by the question and answer portion, I may explode. So the pressure is always on, but the pressure is actually really on our judges. So why don't we go ahead and meet our distinguished panel of judges. Let's meet this year's Miss Universe Philippines judges. Here we go. Our first judge. Recently hailed by People Asia magazine as a woman of style and substance this year. And she is the commercial director of Hilton Manila. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Joanne Golang Gomez. Our next judge is the vice chairman of Air Asia Philippines, voted the biggest budget airline in Asia for 11 years. She is also the CEO of Global City Mandaue, the newest township project in Cebu. I present to you Sheila Romero. Our third judge is the CEO and co-founder of Asia's number one and most trusted health and beauty company, Front Row. He gives most value to helping and inspiring others through his story of triumph and through his foundation, Front Row Cares, and Escuela Centers. He was recognized as Philanthropist of the Year this year. Give it up for Sam Versosa. Our next judge is a pioneer in the field of aesthetics. She introduced the Philippines to Botox and to Mesent liposuction. She continues to search the world or the universe for the best it has to offer in the field of aesthetics and dermatology to bring home. The doctor to the stars and the founder of medical director of Bello Medical Group, the one and only Doctora Vicky Bello. Last but not least, he is known for his minimalist style and exemplary tailoring. In 2015, his Red Charity Gala collection was exhibited at the Cultural Center of the Philippines, the first show of its kind in the institution. A former president of the Young Designers Guild and the Fashion Designer Council of the Philippines, judge number 4, renowned fashion designer Joji Lioren. And there you have it, this year's panel of judges for Miss Universe Philippines 2021. Of course, also with us, we have our guest panelists this evening, Mr. Joey Gilas, Director for Corporate Communications of Resorts World Manila and news anchor and host, People's Television Network. Also introducing our gracious host for tonight and the man behind the biggest resort in Bohol, Henin Resort Alona Beach, the president of Henin Group of Resorts, Mr. Alfonso Louis Chusoy. Thank you, guys. Dr. Abello, look at this. Dami, ah. Okay. It's like hot dogs. The Miss Universe Philippines 2021 is made possible because Miss Universe Philippines is an IATF compliant pageant. Only fully vaccinated individuals with negative RT-PCR results are allowed inside the bubble. The Miss Universe Philippines organization is committed to revitalizing the live events, hospitality, and tourism industries in these challenging times. a safety committee composed of Miss Universe Philippines, local government of Bohol, and hotel oversee implement the IATF guidelines. Safety officers and safety marshals are present at all times to make sure that we follow these guidelines. The provincial government of Bohol is our partner in promoting this responsible and responsive way of holding live events and tourism in the new normal. Together, our intention is to inspire our nation and give hope to Filipinos that we can triumph over this pandemic. On that note, we would like to acknowledge the presence of Governor Arthur Yap. Thank you so much. Sir, thank you so much for welcoming us into your beautiful province. We say this often, but literally, this could not have happened without you. We'd also like to thank and acknowledge the presence of Panglao Mayor Leonila Montero. Tito Montero. We'd like to recognize the presence and say thank you, of course, to Mr. Alfonso Luis Chusoy, President of Head In Group of Resorts. Hi again. Mr. Carl Chusoy, Vice President of Head In Group of Resorts. And Dr. Henry Chusoy, Founder of Head In Group of Resorts. Thank you so much. I love my room. It's right by the pool. And special thanks, of course, to the phenomenal men and women behind the Miss Universe Philippines organization. I can't say this enough. I see them every day. I am amazed that you are able to have this event. You know, throwing a pageant is one thing. Throwing a Miss Universe pageant is another thing. Throwing a Miss Universe pageant in the middle of a pandemic is something unheard of. You guys have been bouncing around from lockdowns to bubbles to wherever you, from cars, from vans, from cities, and now we are here and I am proud to be your host tonight. So please, a round of applause for them. Let's start with Mr. Mario Garcia, Marketing and Business Development Head. Mr. Voltaire Tayag, Director of Communications. And now let's meet the Board of Directors. Ms. Shamsi Supsub Lee, National Director. Mr. Jonas Gafud, Creative Director. Mr. Albert Andrada, Design Council Head. Thank you so much for your hard work and dedication. Wow, we did it again. You guys did it. Again, everyone, round of applause for Miss Universe Philippines. All right, so now let's take a look back at the wonderful journey of this year's inspiring and phenomenal women, a journey that they will forever treasure and they will definitely be proud to share to the universe. Well done, ladies. I think that they are, yes, they're definitely ready for one of the most highly anticipated segments in any pageant. I'm talking about the swimsuit competition. They are ready to walk and win in Jojo Bragae's shoes. Cheer on for your favorite phenomenal and inspiring woman as they impress us in their swimsuit, together with Sam Concepcion.
Shawty, I've been feeling lonely. Memories of 2019. On the beach and we vibing. Cold ones on hand, we excited. Good trip, psilocybin. It's me, you, and the horizon. I've been talking about life and I'm locked in. Great girl, self-esteem, and she glowing. And she don't want commitment, but we be both down just to ride in the moment. Craving for the one, but you keep your distance. She only be close when it comes to the. But I be saying yes, cause man, she a 10. High convos on the same wavelength. I don't need money, man, I don't need cash. The only thing I need is a shawty real bad. Oh, the what I'm taking down, my work, my guys, I can who you not that. Oh, the what I'm taking down, my work, my guys, I can now papa EP.
Let's begin the swimsuit competition with Masbate. Here we go, Pangasinan. Misamis Oriental. Manila. Albay. Cavite. Angeles City.
Who knows now that I'm
Pantanuyong. Taguig. Cebu Province. Laguna. Paranaque. Romblon. San Juan. Cebu City.
tao, kay gandang diwa tao. Kahit saan padalhin, araw-araw gabi. Diwa tao, kay gandang diwa tao.
There you have it, our amazing top 16 with, of course, the very talented Sam Concepcion. You know, it's really inspiring to see them at their best wearing the Albert Andrada Lux Sports because it motivates us to be the best versions of ourselves as well. And I just love all of them for that.
I absolutely agree, Billy. Did you see those girls? They were beautiful. I could actually imagine myself wearing that, can't you?
Same.
Congratulations to all the beautiful ladies and, of course, to Sir Albert. At this point, we would like to thank our sponsors who made this show possible. Front Row, Shine Up Front. Cream Silk, conditioned for greater. Lazada, iniisip mo palang, nasa Lazada yan. Sheen, wear your wonderful.
PLDT Home, do it better with PLDT Home. Jojo Bragais, walk, win. Copper Masks, K-Pads, Barley. BYS, MG, Save Point Plus, Center for Advanced Dentistry.
Bioflu, Henan Resorts Bohol, Air Asia, Culture Salon by Jim Ryan Ross, Nick Studios.
LV Transport Services, BCDA, Lipad, Hilton Clark, and Clark International Airport. To all our sponsors, thank you very much.
You know what, Billy? Our candidates, they're not just inspiring for their beauty physically, but also the beauty of their hearts. And speaking of hearts, this year, Miss Universe Philippines partnered with Save the Children.
And beyond sharing the beauty of Filipinas, we want to showcase the universe, the beauty of helping those in need. This will definitely inspire you.
Uncovered grit and my passion to persevere, the unbreakable me.
I have uncovered the version that is sweet.
So the version of myself that I have uncovered is my creative side.
I think I've uncovered a bolder me.
So I have learned not to cover up my flaws, but instead just enhance my features or even go beyond that.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, wow.
Amazing.
Last year, in the first edition of the Miss Universe Philippines, we met a phenomenal woman from Iloilo City. Her inspiring story from her hometown to joining her very first national pageant and eventually representing the Philippines to the Miss Universe 2020 pageant. She won the hearts of many pageant fans from all over the world and universe. Let's take a look back at the beautiful journey of our reigning Miss Universe Philippines, Rabia Mateo.
Miss Universe Philippines 2020 is Miss Iloilo!
It was October 25, 2020, and I remember everything that happened on that day. It was a mix of emotions. I was very happy, but at the same time, since it's a pandemic, I didn't actually have that actual crowning moment. But I think it's a good thing also, because you don't want me to see my ugly cry. And actually, I remember when I called my mom, and my words were, "We made it together. We won the Miss Universe Philippines." it's not just Iloilo City that I'm representing, it's the whole country. And of course, there's pressure added to it. But I am very grateful and thankful to all the people who believed in me, to all the people who were there since day one, helping me with my trainings, seeing the potential in me. But I also am thankful to those people who lifted my spirit during the moments in which I feel like I wasn't good enough. I had a lot of experiences, and in a span of 1 year, I've been into different things. I've had a lot of struggles, a lot of challenges, but I can say that it made me a mature woman right now. It made me realize to be more grateful for what I have. And bad things don't last in life. I think we need to focus on those things that inspire us to be better. Everything is possible as long as you put your heart and your mind into it. And thank you so much for believing in me. To be remembered as somebody who gave her everything to make the Filipinos proud. I am Rubia Oxana Mateo, Miss Universe Philippines 2020.
Once again for Miss Universe Philippines 2020, Queen Rabia Mateo. So, Rabia, tonight is your last night as Queen Rabia Mateo of Miss Universe Philippines. And you promised that you wouldn't cry kanina. Sinabi niya sa akin.
I didn't.
I will not cry. Pero kagabi, you cried.
Yes.
So, how do you feel? How do you feel coming back here tonight?
To be honest, Casey, it's a mix of emotions. I'm excited for the next girl, but also I am getting emotional simply because I'm feeling very grateful and thankful to everybody who believed in me. And I am aware that somehow I'm gonna reach this point, that I'm gonna close the chapter.
Yes. You know, when you won the pageant, you instantly got a lot of new fans. And then when you eventually competed, you got a whole bunch of brand new fans. And I know you're going to continue to have those fans and get more fans throughout your career, whatever you decide to do. So you actually had your reign in the middle of a pandemic, right? Being on stage of Miss Universe Philippines again, what memories like are flashing back to you right now?
Probably that moment before you go out on stage, I remember I was feeling that kaba.
Yeah.
And I would remind our girls that feeling that nervousness is normal. It just means that the competition really matters to you.
True. I mean, if you are too relaxed, you might get too comfortable, right?
Yes.
So do you have any, messages for, the girls backstage? Do you have any advice?
To the girls, just enjoy the moment.
Yes.
If it's for you, it's gonna happen. If not, there's still a next time.
So you have Rabianatics.
Yes.
Yes, Rabianatics. So do you have a message for the Rabianatics and also for the Kalbo Nation?
To all the Rabianatics, thank you so much for making me the source of your inspiration. And Casey, I also want to take this opportunity to thank all of the Ilonggos watching right now. Madamo gid nga salamat sa tanan nga pagsuporta nyo sa akon. Madamo gid nga salamat sa pagpalangga kag pagpangamuyo nyo. And I hope, guys, I made you proud.
I know you did. Of course you did. How about a message for the Miss Universe Philippines organization?
To the Miss Universe Philippines organization, especially to Sir Jonas Gafford and Madam Shamsi Soup-Soup, thank you so much for believing in me and fighting for me. You guys made my dream come true. Salamat talaga.
How about your real-life queen, your mama? You got message for mama?
To my mom, who is watching right now, how I wish that you were here with us, seeing me in my last few moments as Miss Universe Philippines. Thank you so much for believing in me. When a lot of people are telling me that I am not good enough, when people were calling me different names, you were there and you were lifting my spirit. And because of that, my dreams are now achievable. And I love you so much, Mama. I promise to be a good daughter to you. Maraming salamat.
Nothing beats a mother's love, right? All right, so this is a big question. The Rabian Addicts also want to know if they're going to be busy in the future. What is next for Rabia Mateo after you turn over your crown?
Well, Rabia Mateo as a beauty queen is saying goodbye for now, but I am excited to try my chances in show business. I really want to do hosting and acting soon. So hopefully to all of our supporters, to my supporters, I hope that you're still there in my next chapter.
So you would like to be hosting, do hosting?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
I'm gonna take your job.
Yep, so see ya. No, I'm just joking. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, the one and only, the beautiful, the pride of the Philippines, we have come to love you so much and we can't wait to see what is next for Rabia Mateo. Once again, your Miss Universe Philippines 2020 Queen, Rabia Mateo. Just like Rabia, our ladies this year hurtled through various challenges to make it where they are now in this competition. Let's take a glimpse of the online video challenges that these inspiring and phenomenal women had to go through.
The power to shine comes from within. More than what you put on your skin, it's what you take in. You shine when you're grateful, when you're determined, when you enjoy even the little things. You shine when you feed your soul, when you keep your eyes on your goals, when you seize each moment, when you stand tall. Because just like you, self-care is queen. Give light to the universe by being your own queen. Shine up front with Lux Health and Beauty by Front Row.
You are still tuned in to the Miss Universe Philippines live here at Henan Resort Alona Beach in the beautiful province of Bohol. Do I look like a light bulb? No? Only light bulb. Okay. The evening gown competition brings out the beauty and elegance of contestants, but more importantly, it gives tribute to the artistry of the Filipino designer. To our phenomenal fashion designers, thank you so much for sharing your talent with us and to the universe.
My designer is not just my designer, he is also my fairy godmother.
He is also someone I really look up to.
So my reliable constant.
He is my strong pillar.
He has also become my friend.
He is also a partner.
He is also my mentor.
He is also my style advisor.
Very, very close friend.
He is family.
They're also believers.
Very special friend of mine.
He is my fairy godmother.
It's my compass.
He is an inspiration.
He is also my friend.
I was so excited when I saw my evening gown come to life. It was just an imagination, an idea before that. But when I saw it, I felt so excited about wearing it. I felt like this would really bring out the best version of myself.
When I saw my gown, it reminded me that my strength lies not in what I wear, but how I carry myself.
Seeing my evening gown come to life brought out a new character in me. It brought out a true queen, and that's someone who I haven't even seen before. I'm so excited to see myself on that stage.
The first time I saw it, I was so surprised, and upon wearing it, it just added so much to my confidence. I felt like an angel with wings that is ready to fly.
Above all else, after seeing my evening gowns, I felt more empowered and inspired, not only to make myself and my province proud, but also to make my designer and his creative team proud.
Just from the initial sketch, I was actually already so happy with the gown. And when I finally saw it come to life, I was in love. Every time I wear it, I feel like a queen ready for the universe.
Having seen my evening gown come to life, I think that it made me feel so free to express myself.
When I saw my evening gown finally come to life, I was very emotional because it's something that her and I have been working on for a very long time, and she is someone that I've known for almost a decade now, so she knows me in and out. So when I saw my gown, I was just so proud that this gown is a representation of the deeper side of who Katrina is.
Well, to be honest, every time I wear a gown by Cherry Varick, I already feel like a Miss Universe.
I am forever grateful to my designer because when no one believed in me, when no one wants to dress me, he was the one who's there for me.
You know, it's not even just the gown, it's the trust that he has put in me in wearing that incredible creation. So thank you so much.
And I'm beyond grateful and privileged to wear his masterpiece.
I am very grateful to my designer because I do believe that one of the things that makes us stand out on the coronation night is our gown. So I thank you for that.
Being grateful is an understatement because I'm more than grateful and blessed to wear his beautiful creation.
I'm so grateful that they believed in me and that they dressed me and allowed me to have this opportunity to wear such a creation is an honor.
Seeing my design come to life has really empowered me and inspired me to be the best version of myself and to be confident for the coronation night.
Thank you so much, Gerson de Mavivas.
Mr. Frederick Policarpio.
Fernamato.
Kuya Chico Estiva.
Mr. Louis Pangalinan.
Mara Chua and Ushisato.
Bench Ligiev de Port.
Mark Baumgartner.
Mark Ramsey.
Tito Rajo Laurel.
To Edwin Uy. And thank you, Tito Richie Bondo.
Says PJ Floresca.
Cherry Varick.
Mommy Fern.
Sir Philip Tampos.
Sir Junil Dering.
Jun Ray.
Sir Boogie and Sir Winston.
Mommy Gigi Aisa.
Sir Kenny Ladaga.
Ate Nina Richie.
Alfie Desamparado.
Gian Lasala.
Danny Ross Trinidad.
Oliver Tolentino.
Tito Jerry Fernandez.
Mark Francis Pachon.
Aldwin Gardina.
Competition begins with Masbate.
Growing up a miracle child, I've always felt the pressure to make my life mean something, to prove that I am worthy of all that I am blessed with. When doubts come, I remind myself, I am worthy, I am blessed, and so I will share my blessings. I am empowered, and so I will empower others.
After my mom passed away, I was faced with an eating disorder and anxiety. I would look myself in the mirror and call myself ugly. I am glad that I discovered that I don't want to be that person anymore. It wasn't an easy journey, but I definitely came out stronger.
Coming back to Miss Universe Philippines is no small feat. I had to face expectations and carry the burden of my past mistakes. I knew I did good last time, but I know I can be greater. This time, I've taken my journey into my own hands. I saw where I needed to put in the work and define my purpose so that I can become greater for myself, the crown, and the Philippines.
Misamis Oriental.
Just last year, my dad went through depression.
I struggled so much because someone I love so deeply turned into someone I could no longer recognize, and my family had to split apart. However, despite that, I am here. If the word strength was a person, it would be me.
Manila.
I had to take time off college because I was struggling with depression. Thanks to my friends and family, they reignited my will to fight and live. Now I will champion against mental health stigma and empower each and every individual.
Albay.
Greatness begins beyond our comfort zones. After having chickenpox in 2020, I lost my confidence and self-belief. But I know that beauty doesn't come from the outside, but on the inside. And now here I am, overcoming my insecurities and showing the universe what I've got.
Cavite.
As a female working in a male-dominated profession, being underestimated was inevitable. Understanding that being a woman was not my weakness but my strength enabled me to thrive. I am Victoria Velasquez Vincent, an architect and project manager, and I defy the status quo to be greater.
Angeles City.
The pandemic crashed so many dreams, which sadly included mine. After flying for an airline for 3 years, I was retrenched. This forced me to find new sources of support for myself and for my family. Despite the pain, I have become someone who is not afraid to embrace the new. Truly, there are so many things that can only be learned through a storm.
Mandaluyong.
Having been stuck in a foreign country, unsure of when I'll be able to come home due to the pandemic, was a terrifying experience. But I remained courageous and determined amidst all the uncertainty, and I was able to finally come home.
Taguig.
I lost a dear friend a couple of weeks ago, Emmett, who was Mr. Island, and he was the kind of soul that endured bullying. And I was deeply saddened and found myself at loss, but I realized that for us to overcome adversity, we need to remind ourselves that we are humans and have emotions so that we can begin healing and gain our strengths back to achieve true greatness in life.
Cebu Province.
Are probably the most judged women. I had my fair share of harsh words and hate online. At first, it has made me feel less, but I know myself and my strengths, and with the love and support from everyone, I know I am bound for greatness.
Laguna.
I was booed in front of a crowd during my first pageant. That made me question my self-worth and started to doubt myself all the time. However, I was able to rebuild my confidence by channeling my energy through pageantry and by believing in myself. Today, I choose to be stronger. I am Laren May Magnaya Bautista, and I am conditioned for greater.
Paranaque.
Coming into the world of pageantry straight out of left field, so many people turned me down, assuming I wasn't good enough. But with lost opportunities came newfound strength, courage, and confidence. This is the new Ingrid, and I am conditioned for greater.
Romblon.
The
this year broke me in the worst way possible. My father had stroke, so I have to take responsibility and be the bigger person. And with that, one great lesson is learned, that overcoming this challenge makes my life more meaningful.
San Juan.
Going into this pageant, I heard so many versions of, "You don't belong here." But every day I woke up deciding that yes, I do, and that I can be greater. And now I walk on this stage knowing that I was right about me.
Cebu City.
In the height of the pandemic, I experienced a difficult time just as everybody else. But it didn't stop me from joining the Philippine Navy Marines Reserve Force to offer my service to those in need. Greatness is when you learn to value the people around you, especially those who need it most.
Michael Pangalinan presenting your Miss Universe Philippines 2021, top 16 in their evening gowns. At this point, we will be presenting the second set of special awards, so let's get down to business. This year's Miss Photogenic is also our Miss Lux White Face of the Universe, and she will receive 100,000 pesos cash with a celebrity photo shoot courtesy of Front Row and a 1-year supply of Lux White. She is ready to shine up front. Congratulations to Masbate, Kirsten Daniel Delavine. next award is the Miss Lux White Reveal Instabright Stunner. She will also receive 100,000 pesos in cash, plus a celebrity photo shoot courtesy of Front Row, a one-year supply of Lux White Reveal Instabright, and she is ready to shine up front. Congratulations goes to Cebu Province. Next up is our Miss Lux Immune Plus Game Changer. She will also receive 100,000 pesos in cash, a celebrity photo shoot courtesy of Front Row, and a one-year supply of Lux Immune Plus. And she happens to be Cebu City. Special award is from our official e-commerce partner, Lazada. Our Miss Universe Philippines Lazada will receive 50,000 pesos worth of Lazada wallet credits. She is ready to add, of course, to cart with her prize. Congratulations, Miss Universe Philippines Lazada is Masbate! To receive the Miss Cream Silk Award, she will have an influencer deal with a one-year supply of Cream Silk products. Congratulations, because you are conditioned for greater. Cebu City! Our contestants walk the runway in their swimsuit, and one of them stood out among the rest. Our best in swimsuit is Cebu City. Last award this evening, these phenomenal women stunned us in their evening gowns, making their fashion designers truly proud. Take a step forward, because you are this year's best in evening gown. Cebu City. And here we go. From 16, only 10 will remain in the competition. The results have been tabulated and verified by Mr. Alan Ocho, partner of the official accounting firm SGV & Company. Thank you. All right, from this group of phenomenal and inspiring women, only 10 will move to the next round. You're all deserving of a crown, but there can only be one. So here we go, in no particular order. You are part of the top 10. Mandaluyong! Hello, good evening. How are you?
I'm so happy.
I see you have some, yes.
They're my relatives.
Does that feel weird to have your head on a stick?
It does. It's the first time for me.
Okay. As someone who had to overcome insecurities yourself, how does beauty pageants affect body image or self-esteem?
It actually uplifts my self-esteem, because as a very private person prior to this, I am not used to all the attention. And after joining pageants, I see how people see me, and I see how much beauty and confidence I radiate from the comments or even from the posts that I distribute in my social media.
Thank you, and well, congratulations for making it into the top 10, and we will see what happens. Make some noise for Mandalu Yong.
Thank you.
Next up, you may now take your spot. Cebu Province. We meet again.
Hello again.
Yes.
The last time I saw you 2 years ago during the Miss Binibining Cebu.
Yes, I was still bald. And you were still beautiful. So, you have actually joined 7 regional beauty pageants and won all of them. Yes? Oh. Being a so-called undefeated queen, what insecurities do you still struggle with to this day?
The word unbeatable or undefeated is such a big word. Probably I'll go with the word bless, I guess. I'm just really grateful and thankful for everything that I've received in my life, all success that I've achieved. Being a beauty queen, being a model, I also have insecurities, I have imperfections, and I know how it feels to be in a boiling pot. But overcoming them, believing that I have so many people I'm surrounded by so many people who believes in me, and that makes me greater than who I am today.
Thank you so much. The blessed Cebu Province, ladies and gentlemen. Heading to the next round, we have Laguna. Good evening, and how are you?
I'm very happy that I was able to be standing here in the Miss Universe Philippines stage.
Such an achievement already, yes?
Yes.
All right, here is a casual question for you. What technological innovation can you, and your advocacy of anti-bullying? Sorry, I'll repeat that. What technological innovation can help your advocacy of anti-bullying?
Since we are in the pandemic time, I made a Let's Talk movement. It's an online messaging that people are safe to express their opinions on their stories, and without any judgment, we were able to uplift and empower one another.
Well, kudos to all of your work, and may you continue to do that and continue to fight the bullies. Ladies and gentlemen, again, Laguna. Also advancing into the next round, Masbate! And how are you, Kisses?
Casey. Hello.
There you go.
Casey, I am doing very good because my mom and my dad, two of my biggest supporters in life, are here. I can't ask for anything more.
There they are. Happy and proud parents, I see. All right. So this is quite a different journey for you. You often speak about being a miracle baby. How was this part of your life affected the way you've approached a pageant like this?
Well, it has affected me in a way that I'm always true to my core. I remember that every moment, I am a miracle. God could have let me die, but He put me here and I have a mission to fulfill, so I'm gonna forget all my doubts and focus on His vision. I will cling into that.
A woman on a mission, ladies and gentlemen, Masbate. Congratulations for making it into the top 10.
Thank you so much.
the fifth spot goes to Cavite. Good evening.
Good evening, Casey. How are you?
I'm fine. I'm fine. You guys have the hard job tonight. I just talk, and you guys actually have to put on the show. So I do not envy your position. So with that said, I will ask a question. You are an advocate for heritage conservation. For a country with limited financial resources that isn't able to provide even the most basic of needs like food, shelter, and healthcare, how would this be beneficial?
Honestly, as Filipinos, I think we need to take pride in our culture, and it doesn't need to even cost anything. It could be something as little as learning to speak Tagalog or learning to speak another dialect. For example, I was raised in New Zealand, and I wasn't raised to speak Tagalog, but I'm now 26 years old, and I am trying my absolute best to keep our language alive. So most definitely, it is a powerful thing to keep our heritage alive, and it's so incredibly important.
I would quiz you in Tagalog, but I'm the worst one also, so let's not do that.
At least I'm better than someone.
Ladies and gentlemen, again, Cavite. The next slot is saved for Albay. Janella. So it says here there are people who feel that their vote wouldn't make a difference. So how do you inspire these people to go out and vote in next year's election?
You know, right now there's a lot of things happening in our country, and we, the common people, have the power to make a difference. And I want you to have that power by putting on your votes, so we can have the right leaders for our community. Thank you.
Yes, that's true. As I say, every vote counts.
Yes, I agree.
Agree. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Albay. Only four names are on the list. Congratulations to Taguig. Good evening.
Good evening.
All right. It says here that in your interviews, you often talk about your mother and your grandmother. What would you tell a young girl who feels lost and does not have strong female role models in her life?
I would tell a young girl that a role model can come from anyone. It can be someone that you know, as long as they aspire and inspire you, and as long as there's someone who pushes you to be your best. It can be a neighbor, your teacher, your classmates. And I'd also remind her that just try to find the good in someone, because you never know. One day, she can also become a role model for someone else as well.
Thank you, Katrina. Ladies and gentlemen, Taguig. You are one step closer to your dream. Paranaque!
Hi, Casey.
Hi. Your whole family is here.
They're so supportive. I'm so, so lucky that they're here for me tonight.
I rode with them on the plane. They're very tall. Your whole family.
We are a tall family.
Very tall family. All right. So you've lived in different countries and traveled the world from a very early age. How has this shaped the views that you have on cultural differences and your general view of the world?
Well, I think that traveling a lot and living in different countries really allows you to open your mind to things. It allows you to think about things in a way that isn't originally how you thought. So I would say that traveling really brings me to understand differences of people and be mindful of who they are and really to just be one with everybody.
It's all about experience, correct? Ladies and gentlemen, Parañaque. Right, only two spots remain, and one of those goes to Pangasinan.
Hello, good evening.
Hi, Maureen, how are you?
I am good, how are you?
I'm still standing here, I'm still okay.
That's great to hear.
It is. All right, so what's more fulfilling for you, right? Being a model or a beauty queen? And how different is Maureen the model versus Maureen the beauty queen?
Oh, the model is actually very insecure, but the beauty queen is a spokeswoman. And as a spokeswoman, I would really like to uplift the stories and experiences of those who don't have the privilege to be on this stage, because I would like to be the voice and make a difference in their lives. Being a beauty queen just means living my purpose.
I think we've definitely seen you grow from model to spokesperson. Ladies and gentlemen, Pangasinan.
Thank you.
All right. The last woman to advance into the top 10 is Cebu City. Good evening, Bea.
Good evening, Casey.
How are you?
It's nerve-wracking to be always called last.
Yes, and you are going to the next round, so yes, it's only
I'm
going to be
happy,
even more
course.
Nerve-wracking for you. So you are you are beautiful because of your bravery, because
you
are out and proud, a member of the LGBTQIA community.
Yes,
do you
I
think
am.
The Philippines is ready to send a member from your community to the Miss Universe pageant?
I honestly believe that our country has definitely been in a long way in battling our fight for equality, especially for the LGBTQIA plus community. Our country have been very supportive, and I definitely think that we are definitely ready to send someone, an LGBTQIA plus member, to the universe.
I know we are too, and well, I hope you're ready because you are continuing on in this pageant. Ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. Your top 10, and one of them will be the new Miss Universe Philippines.
Congratulations to our top 10. Pauline, I don't know about you, but I was getting goosebumps a while ago.
Same here. I was sitting right next to you.
I know. Ladies, you're one step closer to the crown, but it's not yet time to relax. So just know that the competition is about to get tougher and tougher.
And to those who didn't make it to the top 10, we are still immensely proud of you. You're all phenomenal queens in your own rights. And remember, the sisterhood that you gain here remains forever. Michelle, what advice can you give to the ladies who did advance to the top 10?
Ooh, Well, we all know they've worked so hard to get where they are right now in the Miss Universe Philippines stage. And now is just the time to be themselves, do their best, and don't forget to have fun.
I couldn't agree more. And at this point, we would like to thank our sponsors. Bello Sun Expert. Only Bello touches our skin. Who touches yours? And to all our food sponsors here in Bohol, daghang salamat. Green Thumb Farm, the Seafront Grill and Restaurant, the Front Food Park, Chef M, Paeng's Fried Chicken Main, Sayas Restaurant, Tamper Coffee Shop, Painitang Bolanon, Lik Lik Resto, Sweetness 88-1031, City Government of Tagbilaran, and of course, the Bohol Association of Hotels, Restaurants, of Hotels, Resorts, and Restaurants, rather. And of course, the Provincial Government of Bohol, headed by Governor Arthur Yap.
Thank you also so much to Mango Works, Polina Swimwear by Mikey Andre, Christopher Munar Accessories, My Madam Productions, DR Events, Active Events, Municipality of Panglao, and of course, the province of Bohol. And speaking of Bohol, everyone, our very own Boholana right here. Pauline, how's it right now in Bohol? How's the tourism going as well?
Actually, Michelle, the government in Bohol has actually been very active in keeping the tourism industry running. And kudos to the provincial government and to the private sector for working hand in hand in not only taking care of tourists that come in here, but of course the locals too. So that this way, we get to share the beauty of Bohol.
I agree with you, Pauline. You know what? I felt so welcomed here and just so appreciated by all of the locals.
Oh, so you got a real Bolanon welcome then.
Yes, definitely.
So is there any other place that you'd like to go to still here in Bohol?
I've visited Bohol already before. I've been to the Chocolate Hills, I've been to the Tarsier, I've been to the river, ate the buffet, of course. But where I haven't been actually is underwater. I love to scuba and I haven't been able to dive here in Bohol. And Pauline is also a certified diver, right?
Yes, certified mermaid na.
Mermaid also, like me. And she's going to be my tour guide.
Exactly. I will take you underwater.
We started our competition tonight with 28 phenomenal and inspiring women. We gave away 16 awards, including those from our generous sponsors, plus our best in national costume, swimsuit, and evening gown. Then we had to say goodbye to 12 ladies to make room for our top 16. The next round was the swimsuit competition. Definitely a fiery one. It didn't end there because after that we had the evening gown. The ladies paraded in their beautiful gowns by phenomenal Filipino designers. From 16, we met our 10. They showed us their wit in our casual interview. It was a tough task for our judges because all the ladies are deserving of crowns. In a few moments though, we will be announcing our top 5. And from that batch, the new queens will emerge. But before that, here are the prizes awaiting our new Miss Universe Philippines. All right, as you can see, we have our top 10 right here on stage, all hoping that they make it into the final stretch of the competition. And in a bit, we will actually find out who they are. The results are in, tabulated, of course, and verified by Mr. Alan Ocho, partner of our official accounting firm, SGV and Company. Thank you. The envelopes get smaller and smaller as we go. It's cute. Here are this year's top 5. The first spot belongs to Cebu Province. Next to advance to the final round is Cebu City. three spots left, and you may now take yours. Taguig! Only two spots remain, and there are seven names still here on stage. This is your lucky night. Cavite! The last phenomenal woman to clinch the final spot in the top five is... Pangasinan! There you have it, Philippines. This is your top five. And one of them is going to be the next Miss Universe Philippines 2021. The final question and answer portion happens right now. So we have five envelopes right here containing different questions. For this round, we will give them 30 seconds to answer. When they hear this sound, time is up. This is their last chance to convince the judges that they deserve the crown, so our judges are definitely going to be listening intently. Ladies, we have five envelopes here. All you have to do is tell me which envelope you pick, and I will read the question, okay? Shall we begin? Are you ready? Judges, are you ready? Yes. All right, let's go ahead and start with Cebu Province.
Number two.
Number two. All right. Question number two. How will you empower young women and help them become more socially aware?
Hello, good evening, everyone. Now with social media, this tool has been a driving force in all of us. But we have to draw a borderline so that this youth will not take advantage of the social media. We have to see the social media, like how it is, the way it is designed, and that is to unite people and never to divide us in the first place. We have to be responsible users. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Cebu Province. All right, Cebu City, you are next. Pick a number. She says number five, correct?
Yes, that's right.
Question number five. Remember, you have 30 seconds after I finish reading the question. If during your reign as Miss Universe Philippines, things happen in your life that make you sad and uninspired, how would you be able to continue inspiring others?
It is very evident that all of us went through difficulties during this pandemic, but it is also proof that we are able to rise to the occasion. And if anything happened to me during my reign, I will not give up and inspire others by rising to the problems that I am encountering and by inspiring them that whatever you're going through, you will be able to overcome it.
Thank you so much, Cebu City. Okay, here we go with our next beautiful contestant, Taguig. Evening Katrina. Choose a number. Question number four. What do you think is the most inspiring quality that a Miss Universe Philippines should possess and why?
It would have to be the ability to have compassion and relate to other people because, as we know, Miss Universe has to be able to connect from people in all different countries, from all different classes. So I would have to say relatability and compassion because as a Miss Universe, it's your job to inspire others and to genuinely want to help, whether it be the organizations or any companies or groups of people. So there you go, compassion and, of course,
this Katrina, the gig, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
Next up, Cavite. All right.
Could I please have number three?
Number three. In your journey to be Miss Universe Philippines, what has been the most inspiring part and why?
Especially during the pandemic, people have risen to overcome everything that they've gone through. And I've been incredibly privileged and I haven't had to go through that many issues in my life, but meeting so many people who have had so many battles and hearing their stories and hearing how they overcame them, that's what inspires me. That's what inspires me to continue to help the Filipinos in the way that I know how, which is through my advocacy, through architecture and heritage conservation.
Thank you very much. Round of applause for Cavite. All right, Pangasinan. Let me guess.
Hello again.
One.
Yes. That's right.
All right. Here's your question. Are you ready?
Yes.
If you win the crown tonight, how will you inspire other women to get out of their comfort zone?
Just me being here, I am getting out of my comfort zone. I am conquering my fear because I am afraid to talk in front of a lot of people. But I hope that through me, I get to inspire so many to do the same, to achieve their dreams, but to also reach for the universe.
Thank you so much. Once again, round of applause for Pangasinan. There you have it, our question and answer and microphone number calling competition. It's really a difficult task to win Miss Universe Philippines, but it's going to be worth it in the end. Well done, ladies. When we return, let's take a final look at our final five and say thank you and goodbye to our reigning queens. All that and more when Miss Universe Philippines returns live from Bohol.
I walk. I think.
And this is the walk that inspired me to win.
Walk, win.
Back-to-back musical treats, Michael Pangalinan and Sam Concepcion.
All through the night, pour the wine.
We all make mistakes, it is what it is. Who am I not to forgive? I won't point the blame, I won't call no names. I know you still feel the same. Oh, no, no, don't worry now. If love is in your heart, we're gonna figure out. Never let go, stay together. I'm like, oh, nah, nah, you see the light. The sun is on your side through the dark times. I'll be there if ever you feel lonely. Soon as the wind dies down, we'll keep on rising. My hands won't let you drown. Just keep fighting for me. Don't let your fears give you pain when it's storming. Soon as the waves die down, we'll keep on rising. Some of these days just feel different. I feel the weight of the world. I'm praying to whoever listens. And I'm thinking about tomorrow. Why should we cry some more? And oh, nah, nah, don't worry now. Love is in your heart. We're gonna figure out. Never let go. Stay together. I'll be like, oh, nah, nah, you see the light. The sun is on your side through the dark times. You feel lonely. Soon as the waves die down,
you'll keep on rising.
My hands won't let you drown. Just keep fighting for me. Don't let your fears give you pain when it's storming. Soon as the waves die down, world turns and we still learn what it is to be somebody. When time's hard, we pray hard. Lord, give me a Saturday. Let's find ways and better days. Understand it takes some time. As the world turns, we still learn we're all gonna be okay. Soon as the waves die down,
we'll keep on rising.
My hands won't let you drown. Just keep fighting for me.
And we're back. The pandemic has changed the landscape of beauty pageants all over the world. Beauty queens remain relevant as they serve as beacons of hope and silver linings in these challenging times. In 2020, the new Miss Universe Philippines organizing body held their very first pageant that paved the way for their pioneer batch of phenomenal queens. A year has passed, and they are now about to take their final bows. To the Miss Universe Philippines 2020 queens, thank you. Philippines 2020 fourth runner-up, Billy Hackinson. Miss Universe Philippines 2020 third runner-up, Pauline Amalinx. Miss Universe Philippines 2020 second runner-up, Michelle Gumabao. Miss Universe Philippines 2020 first runner-up, Bella Ismael. Miss Universe 2020 Queens. Presenting this year's final five. And one of these five phenomenal women will be the next queen. Cebu Province. Cebu City.
Taguig. Cavite. Of Miss Universe Philippines 2021. Ladies, after months of sacrifice, trainings, and hard work, we have finally reached this point. A new queen will be crowned. The results are tabulated and verified, of course, by Mr. Alan Ocho, partner of our official accounting firm, SGV and Company. May the best phenomenal woman win. Thank you, sir. Miss Universe Philippines second runner-up is Cebu Province. Miss Universe Philippines first runner-up is Pangasinan. Miss Universe Philippines Charity is Cavite. This is the moment of truth. Only one of you will be crowned. The first name I will call will be our new Miss Universe Philippines 2021. In the event that the winner is unable to fulfill her duties, the Miss Universe Philippines Tourism will take her place. Best of luck to both of you. The Miss Universe Philippines 2021 is
The Miss Universe Philippines 2021 is Cebu City! That means that Miss Universe Philippines Tourism is Taguig. Miss Universe Philippines 2021, please take your first walk. Universe Philippines 2021.